Hello, I'm Chris Strawn, one of the librarians here at Northeastern Illinois University. The purpose of this video is to introduce you to NAICS codes and to show you how to do industry research using these codes. NAICS stands for North American Industry Classification System. This system assigns codes to various industries, which allows us to compare them. So let's say, for example, that we're interested in learning more about the veterinary services industry. This has a NAICS code of 541940. Once we know this code, we can use various databases and datasets to look at aspects of this industry, such as total revenue, number of employees, and major players within this industry. The reason we use codes instead of words is because language is constantly changing, and we don't always use the same words to describe things. Consider, for example, the synonyms aviation and aeronautics. Which one would you choose? As it happens, NAICS uses terms like air transportation and aircraft manufacturing. So it's so much easier to use a code rather than trying to remember the exact wording every time. Another reason we use codes is because the people who use NAICS don't all speak the same language. Remember, the first two letters in NAICS stand for North American. This is because NAICS is a joint effort between the U.S. Office of Management and Budget, Statistics Canada, and Mexico's Instituto Nacional de Estadística y Geografía. It's hard enough to think of search terms in just English. Imagine if you had to do the same thing in Spanish and French. NAICS was adopted in 1997 to replace the older SIC, or Standard Industrial Classification System. You may run across older publications that reference that system. And every 5 years, NAICS is revised, which means that it was last revised in 2022, and before that in 2017. This is important to know because you may run across publications and databases that still use the 2017 version. If you're finding strange results, it is likely that the 2017 version is still in use. Before we move on to searching for and using NAICS codes, you should be aware that NAICS is very common in the United States, Mexico, and Canada, but it's not a universal system. In the U.S., Standard & Poor's and MSCI developed their own industry classification called GICS, G-I-C-S, or Global Industry Classification Standard. This is primarily used by Standard & Poor's and MSCI, but you may encounter it in other places. And if you're interested in industries in the rest of the world, you will likely encounter ISIC, ISIC, or International Standard Industrial Classification, which was created by the United Nations. There are other systems used in other countries as well. For the most part, you can find equivalent terms between systems, which allows us to find information about both North American and international industries. So keep this in mind and be sure to check that you're searching with the correct system. The best place to look for NAICS codes is on the Census Bureau website. I've included a link in the description. What's nice about this website is that it not only allows you to search for codes in the 2022 release, but also the 2017 and 2012 releases, which means that you're not out of luck if you encounter a publication or database that is out of date. On the same website, you can also download full publications in PDF format, as well as a list of changes between the 2017 and 2022 revisions. For the purposes of this exercise, let's imagine that you're interested in making paper, and you want to know more about the industry. In the search box, let's enter the term paper and see what we find. We get a lot of results, so it's worthwhile to scroll through them to see what matches our interests the best. You'll notice that there are a lot of the same codes in the search results list. That's because there are many similar industries that are grouped together under the same code. In the case of our search for paper, let's select 322120. This groups together a lot of industries that are related to paper manufacturing. And we can click on any of these because it's all basically the same code. Once we've made our selection, we see a description of that industry, links to related codes, and a list of sub-industries that are included in this code. We can also see the 2017 and 2012 codes for these industries, so you can see how these codes have changed over time. Something to keep in mind is that the codes have a built-in hierarchy. Under the Reference Files tab, we see a breakdown of this hierarchy. So the relevant code that we just looked at, 322120, is a code that begins with digits 31 through 33. Which are all grouped together. And these are all manufacturing. We can click through and see how this is broken down even further. And we see that codes contain a variety of numbers of digits. The longest a code can be is 6 digits, but shorter codes can be useful if you're interested in broader categories of an industry. Once we have the codes, we can use them to find data. Before we start doing this, we need to clarify a couple of things. One is that many businesses could be assigned to multiple codes. So for example, Amazon sells a huge variety of products, offers music and video streaming services, and is a major cloud hosting provider. All of these involve multiple codes for multiple industries. The other point to know is that there is no central organization that assigns industry codes to businesses. The US Census might use different codes for a given business than one of the many research databases. So businesses are not assigned official codes, and different organizations might see a business's industry differently. Since we've already started with the census, let's begin there. The United States Census Bureau not only counts people, it also gathers statistics on business. This happens every 5 years and coincides with the years that NAICS codes are updated. So the most recent NAICS code update happened in 2022, and so did the latest economic census. I'll include this link in the description. Because it takes a lot of time to analyze all of the data that is collected, we only have preliminary results for the economic census as of July 2024, but it's still useful. So let's start with the first look. This takes us to a bunch of really broad tables broken down by industry. As we scroll down, we see a lot more tables, but these haven't been released yet. So the latest release for a lot of these top tables is January 2024. But if we click down, we see that some of these tables won't be released until 2025 or even later. So we could check back when these tables are ready if it is something that we're interested in. So let's stick with the paper industry, again, which has code 322120. This is a type of manufacturing. So let's select the manufacturing table right here. And then once we're in, we can apply some filters. We are given a list of broad categories within the manufacturing sector. So now remember, our code starts with 322, and we see that this is listed under the table paper manufacturing. This is a big table and it's really hard to read with so much data, so we can apply a filter to select this industry and none of the others. Before we do that, one quick tip, if you click on these three dots, you can read the cell notes, and this gives us an overview of what exactly is meant by the paper manufacturing industry. So the filters for the census data are on the left-hand side. So let's scroll down, and this will take us to codes, and we can select NAICS codes. Under manufacturing at the bottom, we have a list of industries, just like we did in the table, and we can select paper manufacturing, again, 322. Check the box here. And now our table is only the information for that industry. So we can close out this filter. We can collapse this list of results, and we can pop up the list of results and filters on the left anytime we want to. So we still have a ton of data. We've got, for example, information that there's 2,295 firms, 3,876 establishments, annual payroll in thousands of dollars, so on and so forth. And if it's hard to read the headings, you can either hover your mouse over the heading and it'll give you the full thing, or you can hover over the break in between the two different headings and you can expand them so you can read the entire thing. So there's a lot of things you can do with census data. So much that we don't have time to discuss all of it. But one important thing to know is that if you are interested in downloading this data, you can download it in a variety of formats, so Excel, CSV, or as a zip file, so you can examine and manipulate the data on your own computer. There's also a very handy cite button. So if you are ever writing a report, you can click here and it gives you citation information in a variety of formats. Census Data is great because it's completely free to use, so you don't have to be affiliated with a university or a library to get to it. And the Census Bureau has other statistics that might be relevant to industry research, so I recommend clicking around to see what else is out there, or contacting a librarian if you need assistance locating specific information. Other government agencies, which also have completely free data, so for example, the Bureau of Labor Statistics, they also use NAICS codes. So these codes are a great tool to have anytime you want to research industries. A good place to see what other government agencies have relevant information is at USA.gov, which is a search engine that allows you to search all government agencies. The other place we'll look today is a database called IBISWorld. This is not a free service, so you'll need to get access through a university library or some other place. I've added a link for NEIU users in the description. This will only work if you log in using your NEIU NetID and password. IBISWorld collects data on industries from a variety of sources, including government sources, and presents this data in a way that is really easy to understand. You can access IBISWorld from the NEIU Libraries Business Research Guide, which you can access here by clicking on Research Guides and then scrolling down to Business. Or we also have a full list of library databases, and you can select it from that list. Within the Business Information Research Guide, it's under Industry Information, right here. Once we've logged in, we can begin our search. So what I'm going to do is enter the code that we found earlier, 322120. So you'll notice that this does not give us the results that we expected. And if you scroll down, you'll notice that IBISWorld only uses 5-digit codes, which are just a little bit more broad than the 6-digit codes that are also available. So it's really easy to get a 5-digit code. All you have to do is remove the final digit from the original 6-digit code. And so for our example, that leaves us with 32212. And in this case, that is the very first result. So one thing to notice is from the search results page, we get some brief information, sort of a snapshot of information. But then when we click through, we get a full report. This report starts with the at a glance section, and this gives us a sort of solid overview of the industry. And then if we're interested in further information, we can select some of the other chapters. So keep in mind, this is in the United States, so even though NAICS is North American, we're not getting information on Canada or Mexico here. IBIS does have some information on industries throughout the world, but for the most part, it provides United States-centric information. So we can see that there is a revenue of $34.6 billion. We've got a bit of a trend exhibited here, as well as a predicted trend, number of employees, number of businesses, profits, so on and so forth. We continue clicking, we can get information on the performance. So we see that revenue has dropped and is predicted to continue to drop. And then we have a variety of other tabs. So we can click here, shows how many employees are employed in this industry, employees per business, so on and so forth. It gives us past trends and predicted trends. So a 5-year outlook. And on the left, you can scroll down through the variety of chapters. So there's a lot of key takeaways. So for example, paper is becoming less and less popular simply because most publishing ventures are switching to online. We see that this industry is broken down into a number of products. So paper, just regular old paper, provides 9.6 billion of the industry. Paper towels, which is huge, 5 billion, other sanitary products, including toilet paper, 11.5 billion. And we can see, for example, within this industry that digitization is affecting the paper part of this industry, but the sanitary products and paper towels portion of the industry is doing just fine. There's a really nice geographic breakdown. So this is a fairly small industry. Other industries might have establishments in every state. It looks like North Dakota and Montana and Wyoming have nothing, but for example, Wisconsin has 7.6 of the business establishments in the United States. We've got a nice table here that provides all sorts of information. And usually for any data that is provided, you can download it in some format. So this map, we could download it as an image. We could download the data from the map as a CSV file. Same thing with this table here. We could download it as a CSV file. Under companies, we can see some of the major players in this industry. So Packaging Corp of America is by far the largest player. Got all sorts of information on the external environment. If you keep scrolling around, you'll find SWOT analyses, all sorts of really fantastic information. And if you're interested in downloading the entire report, you can click here on this download report, and it will provide you with a file that you could read when you're offline. One of my favorite sections within IBIS World is this about this industry, which provides a really, really great complete snapshot. So it gives a definition of the industry. This is very similar to the definition provided on the Census Bureau's NAICS website. We've got a bit of a glossary of terms that are used. We have a listing of companies that are involved in this industry. And the related industries is really great because it provides a view of the supply chain, potential competitors, and related products. So again, we're talking about paper manufacturing. Paper is made for the most part from wood pulp. So wood pulp mills is another industry that we might be interested in because that would inform where we get our raw product from. Likewise, paper is sold through paper wholesalers or office stationery wholesalers. So those are industries that we might find interesting. So if we return to IBIS World, we can click on this link here. Let's say we were having issues figuring out what NAICS code we wanted to use. We could just type a term into the search box, say paper again, and we could either select one of the suggested industries, or we could click to view more results. So this gives us 150 results. And so even if the NAICS code is not very helpful, we still have options. So understanding NAICS codes helps us to understand how the United States government views industries, and it helps us find specific information that can be used to conduct research and to make business decisions. If you ever need future research assistance, please feel free to reach out to a librarian, and we can help you find the data that will assist you in your research.